हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द पार्ट टू ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 7 एंड दैट इज कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन फ्रॉम ग्रेड 10. सो नाउ इन पार्ट टू वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट एनिमल नर्वस सिस्टम. सो बिफोर लर्निंग द पार्ट टू ऑफ एनिमल नर्वस सिस्टम वी वॉन्ट टू नो दैट वॉट आर द थिंग्स विच इंक्लूड इन एनिमल नर्वस सिस्टम. So here are the things which we have to learn. So this is stimuli, coordination, nerve cell, synapse, reflex action and reflex arc. These 6 things you have to learn in animal nervous system. So now we'll move on from this portion. So we are starting with stimuli. That what is the word stimuli means? Stimuli means a response which you gave to any of the condition. But by line, if you want to study stimuli, then stimuli is a changes in environment. The changes environment to which living organism response is called stimuli. Means a type of response you gave to any of the changes and any of the condition is stimuli. Now, for the example, it is heat, cold, sound, smell, taste, touch. These all are the examples of stimuli. And your body give response to stimuli by body movements. Means your body movement give response to all these things. So this is all about stimuli. Now we'll move on coordination. That what is coordination means? Coordination matlab sync, a work of togetherness. This is known as coordination. So for a proper response to a stimuli, your body should work together, and this togetherness work is known as nothing else but coordination. Here the working togetherness of various organ in organism to produce a proper response to a stimuli is called coordination. Means ki aapki body ke sare organs ek saath rehke sync mein rehke kaam karte hai aur ek proper response generate karte hai. To ye ek working hai jo saath mein milke hota hai, that is known as coordination. There are mainly 2 types of coordination. Either you can say type or you can say different modes of coordination. This will in animal control and coordination and then plant control and coordination. Now animal control and coordination can be done by nervous system and endocrine system, whereas plant control and coordination can be done by chemical substances which is known as plant hormones. So these are the first 2 things. Now we'll move later. Now, animal nervous system. As I told you, animal nervous system is working by nervous system and endocrine system. Ki in dono ki help se aapki nervous system work karti hai. And the nervous system consists of brain, spinal cord and nerves. Ki nervous system ke andar ye 3 parts hote hai. Now, how did these 3 parts work? So, these 3 works with the help of these 4 green words, that is receptor, effector, sensory nerve and motor nerve. These are the 4 basic parts by which your neuron system, or else you can say nervous system, works. So first of all, you have to learn what is receptors. So receptors are the sense organ which receive the stimuli and pass the message to brain or spinal cord through a sensory nerves. So in simple words, if you want to learn receptor, the receptor means nothing else but your sense organs like your skin, your eyes, your ear, your tongue. These all are receptors which receives the signal and pass the signal to brain, but with the help of sensory nerves. Because these are the sense organ and the signal which is passed to brain is by sensory nerves. Let me take an example. These are the sense organ: eye, ear, nose, tongue, skin. Then so this is a sense organs. So eyes detect light and with the help of receptor, photoreceptor. Ear detect sound with the help of phonoreceptor. Nose detect smell and that is olfactory receptor. Tongue detect taste and that is gustatory receptor. Skin detect touch and that is tangoreceptor. So these 5 are a various type of sense organs and the detection of that and a receptors. We'll move on effectors. Now we'll talk about effectors, sensory nerves and motor nerve. Receptor already you learned, now you have to learn effectors, that what is the word effector means. So effectors are the muscles and glands which responds to the information from the brain and spinal cord through the motor nerves. Already I told you at receptors, that receptors are the sense organ which receives the signal. So at the same way, effectors are the organs or the muscles and the glands which give respond and which gives final answers to any of the condition, but with the help of motor nerves. अगर ना समझ में आया हो, आपको एक सिंपल वर्ड में समझाती हूँ. रिसेप्टर क्या था कि रिसेप्टर्स आर द सेंस ऑर्गन की जो कोई भी चीजों को महसूस करते हैं और सेंसरी नर्व की हेल्प से उसको ब्रेन तक पहुंचाते हैं. बट इफेक्टर्स क्या है कि आपके ब्रेन तक जो सिग्नल पहुंचा है उस सिग्नल के ऊपर प्रोसेस करके वो प्रोसेस किया हुआ सिग्नल वापस आता है और वापस आने के बाद जो एक्शन करनी है वो एक्शन करने का काम कौन करता है? इफेक्टर्स. दैट मींस जहां से एक्शन होती है दैट इज इफेक्टर एंड द इफेक्टर्स आर मसल्स एंड ग्लैंड्स की ये दो ऐसी चीजें हैं जो वर्क करती है और जहां से ये सारे सिग्नल्स वापस आते हैं ब्रेन से वापस आते हैं दिस नर्व्स आर मोटर नर्व्स. पहले वाले नर्व थी सेंसरी नर्व्स और इफेक्टर्स के अंदर नर्व्स होती है मोटर नर्व्स. आई होप यू हैव क्लियर. देन ऑल्सो अगेन आई रिपीट व्हाट इज सेंसरी नर्व एंड व्हाट इज motor nerve. So first of all we have to talk about sensory nerves. That sensory nerves are nerves which carry information from receptor to brain. As I told you, sensory nerve means a type of nerve which pass the signal from receptor to brain. मतलब ऐसी nerves जो receptor से signal लेके brain को पहुंचाने का काम करती है. Now motor nerves. Motor nerves are the type of nerves which carry information from brain to effectors. मतलब motor nerves मतलब ऐसी nerves जो brain से spinal cord से इन दोनों जगह से आपके signals पहुंचाने का काम करती है. Effectors पे मतलब signal वापस लाने का काम करती है. So here are the four basic thing. Now human nervous system. As you all know, human nervous system is consist of brain and spinal cord and the two type of nervous system. So nervous system is consist of two part, that is central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. CNS have also two part, brain and spinal cord, and at the same way PNS is also two part, voluntary PNS and involuntary PNS. If you want to learn detail in human nervous system, then check the video 1. At there you have got the final answer of this. Now the main part of the nervous system, that is neuron, or else you can say nerve cell. As like your body have a cell that is a functional part of your body. At the same way, nerve cell is a functional part of nervous system. So nerve cell, or else you can say neuron, is a structural and functional part of nervous system. Now ये functional part है. Now what are the things which is include in nerve cell? So nerve cell include cyton, nucleus, cytoplasm, dendrites, axon, myelin sheath and synapse. So first of all you have to learn what are the green words means, what is the terminology and what is the definition of these green words. So first of all we'll start with cyton. The cell body of neuron is known as cytone. The cell body of nerve cell is known as cytone. In cytone, the central dense portion is known as nucleus and the jelly-like material is known as cytoplasm. Here the three term is complete. Now dendrites. The branch-like structure is known as dendrites. The outside branch-like structure is known as dendrites. Then axon. The long fibrous chain. Sorry, the long fibrous nerve which looked like a thread is known as axon. Now myelin sheath. Axons have a protective layer, protective cover is known as myelin sheath. And the junction between the two neuron is called synapse. Junction in the sense your body have a number of amount. The neurons are present in lakhs in your body. There are so many thousand and in lakhs nerve cells is present in your body. So in between the neurons and in between the nerve cells, some space are present. At the space the junction is located is known as synapse. And there are two types of synapse, electrical synapse and chemical synapse. We'll learn the difference of these two. Now, message passed through nerve cell in a form of chemical and electrical signal called nerve impulses. If we are talking about brain and if we are talking about nervous system, or else you can say neurology, then in neurology, signals can be written as impulses. So wherever you learn impulses, that impulses means signal. So message passes from the nerve cell in the form of chemical or else electrical signals called nerve impulses. Matlab jo bhi messages pass hote, it is known as nerve impulses. Now how the messages pass? Then the dendritics receive the information, produce a chemical reaction, and this reaction will pass through the axons. I'll explain you with the help of diagram that what is this things, this green words means, and how the signal first of all, we'll learn about the diagram of nerve cell. So this is a wall diagram of nerve cells, or else you can say neuron. Here the skin color part is known as cell body, or else you can say cytone. In this cytone, the skin color part is known as cytoplasm and the central part is known as nucleus. Here you can say the hair-like structures, this portion is known as dendritics, which receives signal. And then just focus on my red arrow, the thin thread-like structure, which is skin in color, this known as axon. Here you can say round formation in purple color, this is known as myelin sheath. At the end of the nerve cell, this is called nerve ending. So here the nervous system, neuron diagram is done. Now I'll show how the signals travels. So this dendritics receive the signal. From here the signal is passed in cytoplasm and in nucleus. From here the signal comes in axon. And from past the axon, the signal will reach at the nerve ending. And from here, from this nerve ending, the signal will pass to another neuron. Now I'll show you how the signals are passed from one neuron to another neuron. So here is this transmission of message through different neuron. So first of all, learning the transmission, you have to learn what is presynaptic cell and what is postsynaptic cell. Presynaptic cell means a type of cell which receives signals first. So that is known as pre. Pre means first, or else you can say before. And postsynaptic cell means a type of cell which receives signal later. Means the second cell which receives the signal. Post means after. So this receives signal first and this receive after first one. Now how the signals and how the message will pass. As I told you, dendritics receives signal. This signals will processed at cytone, or else you can say cytoplasm. From that cytoplasm it pass from axon, and from that axon the signals will reach at nerve's ending. Now these nerve ending are joined with second nerve cell, or else you can say at the cytoplasm, or else on the cytone of the second nerve cell. So from this nerve ending the signal will pass on postsynaptic cell, or else you can say the second cell. Now the signals reach here, and from here the signal will pass again and reach the second nerve ending. From here this nerve will sit on another nerve and pass the signal. From that nerve it will pass the other nerve, and at the same way the signal will pass from one nerve to another nerve. So now here you have to learn what is synapse. So you can see here the junction, that one nerve end are sit on a second nerve cytone. So this joining part is known as synapse. that how the two neurons are joined together is known as synapse. Clear everyone? So this is a message passing of neuron. Now we will have to explain what is synapse and what are the two types of synapse. So now we will learn. So there are total two types of synapses. First one is electrical synapse and second one is chemical synapse. Matlab a two type of junction of between the neuron, that is electrical synapse and chemical synapse. Maybe in your textbook this difference is not given, but prepare this difference because it should be asked in 2 or 3 mark. In your textbook it is not clearly given, but it a different part the synapse will be included. So if I talking about electrical synapse, in electrical synapse pre and post neuron are very close to each other. Pre and post neurons matlab the first neuron and the second neuron are close together, but in chemical synapse there was a synaptic cleft. Here the cleft means space. That means one neuron and second neuron have a space between them, so that is known as synaptic cleft. The second one is electrical current. In electrical synapses the current pass from one neuron to second neuron directly. As I explain you in the previous figure, that it shows that one end of the neuron is directly sit on the second neuron, so this is a direct pass of signaling. But in chemical synapses the signal cannot be directly passed because the synaptic cleft is present, means a space between the two neuron is present, so signals cannot be directly passed. So at that time neurotransmitters is secreted from the synaptic cleft, and these neurotransmitters pass the signal from one neuron to another neuron. Electrical synapses are the faster way to transfer the signal, but chemical synapses takes more time compared to electrical synapse to pass the signal because the synaptic cleft is present. It can be asked in 2 mark question that why transmission is slow in chemical synapses. So you have to just give one reason, that a synaptic cleft is present in chemical synapse, so the signal cannot be transferred as fast as electrical synapse. So the transmission rate is slow in chemical synapse. Getting अगेन आई रिपीट कि यहाँ पे प्री एंड पोस्ट सेल के बीच में जगह बहुत ही कम होती है, बट केमिकल के अंदर साइनेप्टिक क्लेफ्ट प्रेजेंट होता है, मतलब कि दो न्यूरॉन के बीच में जगह होती है जो एक दूसरे को अलग रखती है. हियर करंट और एल्स यू कैन से सिग्नल्स डायरेक्टली पास हो जाते हैं क्योंकि वो सारे न्यूरॉन्स एक दूसरे के टच में है, तो सिग्नल्स डायरेक्टली पास हो जाते हैं. यहाँ पे क्या होता है केमिकल में कि यहाँ पे साइनेप्टिक क्लेफ्ट प्रेजेंट है, इसीलिए केमिकल्स और सिग्नल्स जल्दी से पास नहीं हो सकते. तो ऐसे कंडीशन में क्या होता है, साइनेप्टिक क्लेफ्ट के अंदर एक केमिकल सिक्रीट होता है जिसका नाम है न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर. न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर क्या करेगा कि साइनेप्टिक क्लेफ्ट के अंदर न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर एक केमिकल है जो सिक्रीट होगा साइनेप्टिक क्लेफ्ट में और सिग्नल पास ऑन करवाएगा. इलेक्ट्रिकल साइनेप्सिस में सिग्नल्स जल्दी से पास होते हैं और केमिकल में स्लो पास होते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ अ साइनेप्टिक क्लेफ्ट. सो हियर आई होप दैट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू साइनेप्सेस आर क्लियर. नाउ सम कॉमन पॉइंट्स, दैट इज व्हाट इज रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन एंड व्हाट इज रिफ्लेक्स आर्क. सो रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन इज a sudden and unconscious or else you can say involuntary response of the effectors to a stimulus. मतलब कि reaction है, response है जो आपकी body किसी भी condition को देती है. तो आपको ये एक question होना चाहिए that what was the difference between the reflex action and stimuli. क्योंकि stimuli का मतलब भी response देना था और reflex action का मतलब भी response देना है. तो difference क्या हुआ? तो स्टिमुलाई मीन्स अ नॉर्मल रिस्पॉन्स विच योर बॉडी यूजुअली गिव इज नोन एज स्टिमुलाई. बट रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन मीन्स अ सडन रिएक्शन दैट विल गिव एन अ फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकेंड्स, दैट इज रिफ्लेक्स रिएक्शन. दैट इज आई कैन से अ टाइप ऑफ एक्शंस ऑन विच योर बॉडी डज नॉट हैव कंट्रोल, कि जो एकदम जल्दी से होते सोचे उससे पहले हो जाते हैं, दैट आर द रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन. फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, We suddenly withdraw our hand if we suddenly touch a hot object. कि हम जब भी कोई गर्म चीज को छूते हम क्या करते हैं, अपना हाथ जल्दी से वापस ले लेते हैं। कि तब हम सोचते नहीं है कि हाँ भाई हाथ हटाओ या ना हटाओ, जब तक सोचने बैठेंगे हाथ जल जाएगा। तो हमारा हाथ क्या होता है, ऑटोमेटिकली वापस आ जाता है, दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द इनवॉलंटरी रिस्पॉन्स। तो ऐसे सारे काम की जो इनवॉलंटरी होते हैं, जो जल्दी से हो जाते हैं, सडन रिएक्शन आते हैं, दैट आर द रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन। सो आई होप यू गेट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन एंड स्टिमुलाई। नाउ As I told you, these four things you have to correlate with reflex action. That in reflex action, the nerve in the skin receptor detect the heat and the pass the message to spinal cord with the help of sensory nerve. Then your brain and spinal cord will process the signal and pass the processing signal to the muscles, or else you can say effectors, with the help of motor nerve. And then receive the signal, we withdraw our hand. Again, we'll learn this thing with the help of diagram. But before this, you have to learn what is reflex. So, reflex arc means nothing else but the pathway on which your signals travel is known as reflex arc. Here, the pathway through which electrical impulses, or else you can say electrical signals travel, is called reflex arc. Or else you can write a simple way, the pathway on which electrical signal travel is called reflex arc. Here the same thing, the reflex arc is a stimulus, is received by receptor and passed to spinal cord with the help of sensory nerve. Then brain and spinal cord process the signal and get a message back with the help of motor nerve. Now the diagram. Here the heat is coming and our receptor organs receives the signal. Here the receptor organ is skin. So receptor organs receive the signal and it will pass to sensory nerve. Sensory nerve goes to spinal cord and say the signal to the spinal cord. Now spinal cord process the signal and identify that it was a heat. Then spinal cord gave a signal that withdraw your hand. So this signal will pass through motor nerve and came at effector organ, which is our muscles. Now effector signals got a signal that we have to withdraw our hand, so it gives response, and as and when the response is given, we withdraw our hand. So this is a flow chart of reflex arc. If it is shown like give a flow chart of reflex arc or else explain reflex arc, you can draw this diagram and explain it easily. Again, with the help of image, that here the fumes, the heat fumes is touch your skin. So from this skin, your receptors get signal. This is a sensory nerve, the red arrow or red line. This is a sensory nerve. Sensory nerves pass the signal to CNS, or as you can say spinal cord, the central nervous system. Now this central nervous system processed on the signal and identify which type of signal and which type the message. From identifying the message, it will pass the feedback and message back to the effectors with the help of motor neuron. This red line is of motor neuron where my pointer is located. So this is a motor neuron, and from that motor neuron your signal is passed to इफेक्टर ऑर्गन। मतलब कि आपको इफेक्टर ऑर्गन को सिग्नल मिल गया कि भाई आपको हाथ क्या करना है, हटा लेना है। तो जैसे ही इफेक्टर ऑर्गन को सिग्नल मिलेगा, आपका हाथ तुरंत यहां से हट जाएगा। सो दिस आर द स्पीड ऑफ अ वर्किंग। तो सोच लो ये वर्क कितना फास्टली होता होगा कि आप टच करते हो और फटाक से हाथ वापस ले लेते हो, तो एक सेकेंड में हाथ वापस आ जाता है। तो सोचो ये वर्क फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकेंड्स के अंदर होता होगा। सो हियर the portion is completed. Now in third video we'll learn a hormone system which is in plant and animals. Part 2 is completed. If you have any doubts, same as note down the doubt and then tell me. Thank you everyone.